Kenyan President William Ruto and his Burundian counterpart have arrived in the country today ahead of the Independence Day commemoration tomorrow. These were received at Entebbe International Airport by the State Minister for International Affairs, Henry Okello Odiem, and the State Minister for Defense, Jacob Oboth Oboth. Straight from the airport, they headed to State House Entebbe, where they were received by the host, President Museveni, for the bilateral talks. The delegation will later continue to speak resort Munyonyo in Kampala for the Independence Day dinner. Meanwhile, the office of the president has this evening carried out final touches at Koro ceremonial grounds to ensure that the whole place is lit and ready for tomorrow's celebrations. Colors of the Uganda flag have been decorated on all the tents and security beefed up. According to the Independence Day program put out by the office of the president, guests will start arriving at Koro ceremonial grounds from 8 a.m. The president is expected to arrive by 10 a.m. Several activities will take place, including the parade by the UPDF and other security organs, a military flypast and acrobatics by UPDF commandos.
There will be a number of activities, including parade mounted by the officers and men of the UPDF, the UPF, Uganda Police, Uganda Prisons, and Uganda Wildlife Authority. There will also be a military fly past.
The celebrations are going to be held in a scientific manner. Only 800 invited guests are to physically attend the ceremony, while the rest of the world will watch it live from their homes. Relatedly, the young people have today gathered at the Uganda Museum for the Independence Day celebrations, which they termed Kweshunga. They commended the NRM government for the peace and Uganda at large, a clear signal for the country being fully independent.
The independence of our country and also independence of our bodies. If anybody wants to control you, do you know the first thing they first control? Your body. And play is one of the things that gives freedom for us to get out of our bodies and have an out-of-body experience and just experience life as differently as it can be.
In many societies, one of the things that shows that individuals have a level of freedom is how much they are allowed to engage in co-curricular activities.
October 9th, a declaration of African interdependence and our shared destiny is the theme for this year's independence celebrations. Jaliat Namwaya for the news.